Susan?
How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Good.
It's all right. Compared to the last game I was in here, I was freezing.
I know. I've been complaining about the heat all week. The extra's office has been like 58 degrees, and they finally got it. They said, I don't know how this boiler system thing works. They said the hot water would get to his office.
Interesting.
So now it's
Is he the one on the corner by Brent?
Yes.
Okay.
So now it's a toasted 72 in there.
That was a lot of windows. Did y'all make it through graduation all right?
Yeah, we got a whole lot. Just trying to get everything set back up and working yesterday.
Yeah.
So I'm going to turn it on, start talking.
Okay.
And make sure that the volume's good, because sometimes it gets turned down some kind of way. You can't listen to the broadcast. You got to turn it up to 100 to get the sound.
Okay. So. Is Jordan still coming?
I'm supposed to be.
Okay.
He didn't tell me what, so I got marks up there on music.
Okay. I'm going to say, I saw his name, so
yeah.
I'm assuming.
Nobody didn't tell me they weren't coming, so.
Okay. Cool.
I'll let you know, though.
Sounds good.
Yeah.
the starting lineup for the Francis Marion Patriots. A 6'1", fifth-year senior guard from Tallahassee, Florida, and the reigning Peach Belt Conference Defensive Player of the Week, number one, Tion Rollins. A 6'1", freshman guard from Orangeburg, South Carolina, number zero, Horace Jakes. A 6'4", junior guard from Bronx, New York, number 11, Ibrahim Ouattara. A 6'5", fifth-year forward from Odessa, Florida, and the Conference Carolina's reigning player of the week, number three, Bryce Beamer. And a 6'5", fifth-year forward from Norway, South Carolina, wearing number four, Marlo Gilmore. The head coach of the Patriots is Jake Sender. The assistant coaches, Alex Berga, Patrick Paul, and Corey Ingram. And now, ladies and gentlemen, let's meet the starting lineup for your USC Aiken Pacers. He's a 6'2" sophomore guard. He wears number zero. He's from the city of brotherly love. Meet Jameel Rideout. A 6'3" senior guard out of Toledo, Ohio, wearing number two, Terry Horn. A 6'2" junior guard from Decatur, Illinois, Athens, Georgia, number three, Tyler Johnson. A 6'5" junior guard from Raleigh, North Carolina, and a two-time reigning Peach Belt Conference Player of the Week, Jalen McCoy. And a 6'9" senior forward from Conyers, Georgia, wearing number 21, Devin Evans. The head coach of the Pacers, Mark Vanderslice. The assistant coaches, T.J. Knight and Nicosi Gaddy.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the Convocation Center on the campus of the University of South Carolina, Aiken. I'm Jordan Phillips, joined by Reese Altman for this men's basketball contest between the USC Aiken Pacers and the Francis Marion Patriots. Pacers on a hot streak lately, Reese, looking to pick up another win here.
Absolutely. It's been a while since they've been on the home court here in the Convocation Center, but Francis Marion, no stranger to the trip down I-20, since these two used to be Peach Belt Conference foes. So we'll see how today matches up for both teams.
Pacers looking to pick up their sixth consecutive win, 7-1 start on the season. Tyler Johnson with it for the Pacers to Jameel Rideout. Rideout to Horn. Horn back to Rideout now. Rideout looking for somebody to throw it to. He just takes a little fader, and he drops it down for the first points of this match.
Rideout doing a great job, looking to make a pass, but found himself in the middle of a kind of no man's land in the middle of the defense, able to put it in for two to get the Pacers on the board early.
Ibrahim Ouattara with the ball now for the Patriots, driving it in. He flips to Gilmore. Gilmore off the mark. That's going to be rebounded by Jalen McCoy. Terry Horn with it now. He flips it inside to Devin Evans. Evans finishing off the glass for two.
21, Devin.
To the corner for Marlo Gilmore. Gilmore back to Ouattara. Ouattara driving on McCoy. Turns, fires, off the mark. Ball's loose, and that'll be out of bounds off of Patriot.
Great defense there by McCoy. Also, great job to keep his hands out of the way, not to draw a foul.
That's two times in a row they've tried that drive in on McCoy. We'll see how that works out for him as the match goes on. McCoy bringing the ball up, gets it to Rideout. Johnson, they break the press. Johnson drives Euro off. And it's going to be out of bounds. That'll be off the Patriot. It'll stay with the Pacers.
Yeah, a little bit of content on Tyler Johnson's drive there, but no call by the officials. I think it went off of a Francis Marion defender. So Rideout will take it out of bounds for the Pacers.
Rideout flips it inside to Jalen McCoy. McCoy, jump hook, and a nice finish at the rim.
Jalen McCoy.
Now Ouattara with it. Ouattara flips to Gilmore. Gilmore. Dribbling around the arc, handoff to Tion Rollins. Rollins driving on Rideout. off the mark again, rebounded by Johnson. Solid defense so far for the Pacers.
Yeah, great defense for the Pacers. The Patriots have been doing a great job of being able to get to the basket, just have not been able to convert as of yet.
And a foul on the floor. That's going to go against Ibrahim Ouattara.
Number 11, Ibrahim Ouattara. That's his first and the team's first.
So the Pacers will keep the ball here. Inbound to Devin Evans, Evans to Johnson. Johnson works it inside to McCoy. He's guarded by Ouattara. McCoy turns off the mark, rebounded by Ouattara.
Yeah, McCoy's second time there on the hook shot was just a little bit too strong. Patriots able to pull the rebound.
Ouattara loses his dribble, flips it out to Gilmore, who gets it back to Horace Jock Jr. Beamer with the ball down low. Beamer finishes in off the glass. That's Bryce Beamer with the first points for the Patriots today.
Great job by Beamer there, turning to his right, using the baseline as his friend to be able to go up for two.
Rideout has it now for the Pacers. McCoy, jump hook from the free throw line off the mark. That's going to be rebounded by Ouattara. Rollins bringing it up for the Patriots now. Back to Ouattara. Tara driving. Tried to flip it to Beamer, but it'll go out off of Terry Horn. Tight defense there.
Great job here by both teams. A lot of aggressive defense early. We'll see if this energy stays up as we get longer into the first half.
Yeah, both teams active on defense so far. Gilmore Jr. with it off the inbound. He passes it off to Jakes. Jakes to Beamer. Beamer in the corner, gets it inside. It's knocked away and taken by Devin Evans. Now Jamil Rideout on the run. Rideout flips ahead to Horn. Horn thought about it. He drives instead. Dribbles back out now. The fadeaway off one leg falls for Terry Horn.
Terry Horn thought about the three-pointer earlier, but was able to work his way into the defense to the free throw line and convert for two.
Yeah, one-legged fade shot there. Very nice. Bryce Beamer took that three with a hand in his face. Terry Horn get the rebound. Horn driving now. Flips to right out to Johnson in the corner. Johnson for three and drops it down.
Jamil Rideout very well could have taken that shot for himself, but makes the next pass to get Howard Johnson open in the corner for the three. Pacers up big early.
And a timeout taken by the Patriots here with 16:30 left in the first half. Leads us to our first full media timeout. 11-2 your score. We'll be back in just a moment. Welcome back, everyone. Today's contest presented by Innovative Solutions. For all your printing needs, go to Innovative Solutions. Tell them USC Aiken Athletics sent you. 11-2, your score right now. The Pacers on top after a hot offensive start. Patriots looking to answer. They have the ball, and it'll be out of bounds off of Patriot. Or off of a Pacer, excuse me. It'll be Patriot basketball.
Good look there, trying to get the backdoor pass to the basket, but it was deflected out of bounds. We'll stay in possession of the Patriots here.
Corner three off the mark, rebounded by Evans. That was Fareed St. Cyr on that shot.
And St. Cyr got open off a screen on the inbound pass, just was not able to convert.
Johnson with the ball. He gets the ride out. Ride out back to Johnson. Johnson, semi-contested three, but it won't matter. He drops it down.
And Johnson picks up right where he left off in their last possession. Back-to-back threes for Johnson, almost with an interception there.
To the corner of the shot, and a foul will send Hudson Spivey to the line.
Tough there for Rideout, just a half step too late. Drew some contact, and he'll be going to the line for three.
At the line shooting three is number 32, Hudson Spivey.
Spivey seeing his first action as a Patriot so far this season. He knocks down his first free throw, his first points on the season. Knocks it down the second. So a 3-for-3 trip for Hudson Spivey.
Very rare three free throws back to back to back.
Made him count though. Tyler Johnson with it. He feeds it up ahead to Terry Horn. Horn spins, fires, and a foul.
Terry Horn being aggressive early here on the offensive side. Instead of shooting for threes, he's getting the ball into the interior, fighting into the paint, drawing contact, and also getting to the basket.
Well, as you and I noticed before the game, this Francis Marion team, not the biggest in the world. Biggest player standing at 6'6". That's Chandler O'Bannon. So the Pacers likely going to be attacking the rim a lot tonight.
Yeah, not the tallest team out there, but they, as you've seen so far in the game, they're very fast and very physical, and that can go a long way in the both 20-minute halves here.
It'll be interesting to see the center rotation for the Pacers tonight as Chet LaDelva said to check in. So a 2-for-2 trip for Terry Horn, and Delva's going to check in for Devin Evans.
And something to look at for the Pacers as well. Simeon German also wearing a brace on his knee, so not sure how much action we'll get from him tonight either.
Bringing it up the floor is Teon Rollins. Rollins going to be a turnover for the Pacers. Or for the Patriots, Horace Jakes steps out of bounds.
Yeah, unfortunate there for the Patriots, just half a step out of bounds, but he went across the line. Good call by the officials. Pacer basketball.
Rideout with the ball. Rideout gets it inside to McCoy to the corner for Johnson. Johnson fakes, drives, floater, off the mark, and rebounded by the Patriots. On the drive, flips ahead, and the finish off the glass.
Great pass there.
That was Nico Nurios. Horn fires a three and finishes. A lot of running right now. And that's going to be a turnover for the Patriots. It'll send it right back to the Pacers.
About to say, that pace of play picked up tremendously on those last two possessions. Both teams seemed to handle it pretty well, but just a pass a little bit too far out in front there for the Patriots with another turnover.
Yeah, both teams getting on their horses and running on those last two possessions like you mentioned. Jamil Ride out with it now for the Pacers. They're looking to slow things down. Tyler Johnson fires a three and drops it down. 3-for-3 from the three-point line for Tyler Johnson.
And much like we've seen most of this year, this Pacers team is no strangers to the three-point line. They're hitting them fast and early here today.
And Hudson Spivey, who hasn't seen much any action so far as a Patriot, he's got 6 points tonight and 2 three-point shots.
Absolutely. First time on the floor for the Patriots, but so far he's their leading scorer with 6.
Jamil Rideout off the mark on his three, and a big rebound there by Spivey. Flipped ahead to Jakes. Jakes finishes off the glass.
Excellent finish there from Jakes. I think Terry Horn also got a hand on that ball, so great composure to be able to go up for two.
30-second timeout taken by the Pacers. It's still a 10-point lead here for the Pacers, but Patriots battling back, showing some moxie. Again, a big three on the other end. Take the ball away in a breakaway two-point basket there. And then it's a quick swing, and they're down by 10 now.
But to say, you know, USC Aiken jumped out to that 11-2 lead early, but since then this has been a pretty evenly matched game, scoring 11-12 since that early run. So don't think the Pacers' lead is safe as of right now. We'll see as the game goes on.
Yeah, the Pacers have been hot shooting from the three-point line tonight. So far, 4 of 5 as a team. Meanwhile, for the Patriots, just 1-for-3 so far. That coming off of the shot by Hudson Spivey. But the Pacers got to get a little composure here, got to buckle down on the defensive end a little bit. Again, their offense has not been the issue so far for the Pacers.
It is not, and as we said earlier on the broadcast as well, the Patriots really picked up the pace, getting the ball in quick, using quick figure eights to get up to the basket quickly.
You see a couple Pacers set to check in. Dwight Candy Jr., Rajon Blackwell will come in at the next stop of play. Jamil Rideout with the ball. Devin Evans back on the floor. Chedlet Delva joining him. So the Pacers going big now. Terry Horn with the ball. He flips to Jamil Rideout. Rideout outside to Devin Evans, the big man for the three. Off the mark. Rebounded by Terry Horn. Flips it back to Devin Evans. Evans back to Johnson. Johnson over to Evans again. Evans driving now. Outside to Horn. Horn to Johnson. Johnson drives. Johnson to Rideout. Rideout for three and drops it.
Rideout missed his first three on the evening but makes up for it there with was able to convert, but a hard foul there on the other side.
Hard foul there on Delva. That goes against Ferret St. Cyr Jr. St. Cyr will head to the free throw line to shoot two.
And he's no stranger to the free throw line this year. He's shooting a little over 50%, 14 of 26 on the season.
As he off the mark on that first free throw there from St. Cyr. Blackwell and Kennedy Jr. on the floor now for the Pacers. So a 1-for-2 trip there for St. Cyr. Evans with the ball now. Evans to Rideout. Rideout has to get across half court, and he does. Rideout to Kennedy. Kennedy to Blackwell. Blackwell inside to Evans. Passes tip, but Rideout able to maintain possession. Rideout across the court to Dwight Kennedy. Kennedy for three. Off the mark. Rebounded by Delva. Delva back out to Blackwell now. And a foul. That's a foul on the floor. It'll go against Horace Jakes. Now Demetrius Dixon and Jalen McCoy back on the floor. They'll check in for Rideout and Devin Evans. Dixon with the ball, flips to Blackwell. Blackwell to Kennedy. Kennedy outside to McCoy. McCoy drives, steps, flips it up off the mark and rebounded by Jakes. Patriots in transition now. Jakes, big shot over, big hand of Chedlet Delva on that play to finish that one for Jakes.
Jakes doing an excellent job getting separation there, able to get a clean jump shot in for two.
Blackwell for three. Off the mark, Delva with the tip out. Rebounded by Dixon. Pace is going a little bit cold from three here. Dwight Kennedy now. And he misses everything. That's going to be just a bad mental mistake there by Teon Rollins. Ball was headed out of bounds. It would have been Patriot ball either way, but he tried to grab it and stepped out himself.
Yeah, as you said a second ago, the Pacers have gone a little cold from the three-point line, but they're doing an excellent job on the offensive side, rebounding, being able to get second-chance points.
So the Pacers now with another chance to get on the board. Dixon will inbound. He gets it to Blackwell. Blackwell trapped in the corner. He dribbles his way out. And a turnover for the Patriots.
Great off-the-ball read there to get in the passing lane and get the ball back to the Patriots.
St. Cyr with it now for the Patriots. He gets stopped by McCoy to the three-point line for Rollins. Rollins drops it down. And as you mentioned, you said that big lead wasn't safe, and just like that, it's cut to single digits, a seven-point lead now for the Pacers. Demetrius Dixon with it. Gets it inside to McCoy. McCoy tried to flip it into Chedlet Delva, and it'll be out of bounds off of the Pacers. It'll go right back to the Francis Marion.
Unfortunate situation there from the Pacers. A great read there by McCoy. Just a little bit of miscommunication between him and number 15. That was Delva unable to get to the basket. So another turnover here, and we'll see what happens after the timeout.
That leads us to our second full media timeout. We'll be back in about 45 seconds. Welcome back, everyone. Today's contest presented by Hudson Etheridge Companies and Auto Owners Insurance. For all your insurance needs, contact them and tell them USC Aiken Athletics sent you over. 25-18, your score here in the first half. Pacers with the lead. Simeon German checking in for Coach Mark Vanderslice. Pacers looking to stop a little bit of the bleeding here. The Patriots battling their way back in. St. Cyr with the ball. Cross-court pass to Beamer. Beamer flips it inside to Watara. It's loose and rebounded by, or recovered by, Terry Horn. Dixon with the ball now. Dixon drives, slips it underneath the German. German goes up strong and gets the finish.
Good pump fake there by German to draw the defenders up. Still not able to draw contact, but puts it in for two.
Big crucial bucket there for the Pacers. It had been a while since their last one. St. Cyr with it on the corner. St. Cyr trapped and throws it into German. It'll be out of bounds off of the Pacers.
Great double team there by, I believe it was German and Horn. Nowhere to go. Unfortunately, it goes off of German, unable to control it, and the Patriots will keep the basketball.
A little bit of confusion there. Not sure what happened, but either way, it'll be Patriot basketball. The pass to Beamer, who goes up and gets it. Beamer trapped under the basket. Tried to go up strong, off the mark, rebounded by Watara. Ball's loose, another miss underneath, but another rebound by Watara and a foul.
Wasn't able to comment on it earlier, but just want to give credit to Beamer there. He somehow was able to go up against a triple team and was almost able to put it in.
And I believe the Pacers might have got away with some contact, not only on that shot, but also against the shot from Watara. Either way, they'll be at the free throw line, and it'll be Watara shooting two.
Qatar this year, or Qatar, very good at the line this year, 12 for 14 so far.
And off the mark there.
Make that 12 for 15.
Substituting back on the floor for Francis Marion, number four, Marlo Gilmore.
Rare 0 for 2 trip there from Watara. Either way, the Pacers get the rebound, and it'll be a kick ball, so it'll stay Pacer basketball.
Something we saw earlier from the Patriots was a full court defense. Pacers were able to break that pretty easily. Haven't seen it recently, though.
Dixon with the ball. He flips to Blackwell. Blackwell back to Horn. Works it inside to McCoy. McCoy, jump hook, and the finish.
Basket by number 12, Jim McCoy.
Jim McCoy does love the hook shots from inside the paint.
Rainy.
Two shots so far. See what he can get going.
St. Cyr missing everything, but the rebound made by Marlo Gilmore, and he gets the finish.
Basket to number 4, Marlo Gilmore.
9-point lead for the Pacers now with 9:55 left in the first half. Dixon to the corner for Horn. Back to Dixon. Dixon to Horn now again. Horn back to Blackwell, across the court to Dixon. Dixon inside to McCoy. McCoy to Blackwell. Blackwell for three, and the drops it down for three.
Good look there from McCoy. He drew a double team in the paint, found Blackwell out on the three-point line, able to convert for three.
Inside to Beamer, blocked by German, but the rebound made by St. Cyr in the corner. St. Cyr flips it out with Watara. Watara for three, and he off the front of the iron. Not enough. Horn driving now. Horn loses the ball, but flips to Dixon in the corner. Dixon, the pump fake, the fire, and the bucket.
Good transition three from the Pacers there, pushing the lead back up to 15.
And just like that, the Pacers seem to be hot again from three, and a foul, blocking foul, called against Rajon Blackwell.
Wasn't able to get the charge called, but good job by Blackwell there to stop the transition by the Patriots.
Pacers number one, Ryan Blackwell, his second, the team's fourth. Substituting in as number one, Tina Rollins for Francis Marion. And substituting for the Pacers is number three, Tyler Johnson.
Pass to the corner, Marlo Gilmore. Flips to Beamer. to Jakes. Jakes inside to Gilmore. German with the defense there, and it's going to be a foul.
Great no-look pass there from Jakes getting it down low.
The foul was on the Pacers.
That's going to go against Terry Horn.
His first. It's the team's fifth. And visiting the charity strike will be number three, Bryce Beamer.
So Bryce Beamer will be at the free throw line. Patriots not even going to attempt the rebound. Beamer knocks down the first.
Beamer this season shooting a little over 700 from the 70% from the free throw line.
Now they'll bring in some reinforcements down low to give him a hand. Beamer knocks it down, so a two-for-two trip for him. Demetrius Dixon with the ball now. He gets it to Tyler Johnson. It's loose off of the foot of a Patriot, but recovered by Johnson. Johnson drives, loses the ball, flips it back out to Dixon. Dixon for three. Oh, rims it out. Rebounded by Gilmore.
Almost lost the ball twice there. Great job by Tyler Johnson to keep possession alive.
Johnson gets the ball, flips it back. But it's recovered by the Patriots, and the ball goes to Jakes, who gets the two-point basket.
Credit to Tyler Johnson again, saving that ball from going out of bounds. Unfortunately, fell in the hands of the Patriots.
Yeah, putting his body on the line there, that was nearly bad, but a great effort there by Johnson. Just didn't go the way of the Patriots. Pacers, excuse me. Dixon has the ball. He fires a three-pointer off the mark and rebounded by Jakes. That ball's sent ahead, and it'll be a turnover.
Another no-look pass there from Jakes.
So another media timeout, 35-24 your score. We'll take a break and be back with the conclusion of the first half. Welcome back, everyone. 35-24, your score. Pacers with the lead. Demetrius Dixon bringing it up for the Pacers. Jalen McCoy with it now. Back to Dixon. Dixon feeds to Johnson in the reverse layup.
Tyler Johnson, a lot of off-the-ball movement there, able to get down low with the reverse layup across the baseline.
Yeah, great job staying active and making the play without the ball in his hands from Johnson there. That ball's loose. And recovered by Dixon. It's knocked loose again. Dixon running to Horn. Horn all alone. It's 4-on-1, and Jalen McCoy gets the finish.
Great job there for the Pacers to convert. As you said, a 4-on-1 break.
It would have been very easy for Terry Horn to take that shot there, but again, making that extra pass for an easy bucket. Rollins with the ball. He's guarded by McCoy. Now switched on to Horn. Beamer with it. Beamer nearly loses the ball. McCoy drives, flips, and that'll be Pacer basketball.
Another good look down low. Just a miscommunication between two players, but looks like Jakes and Beamer And ball goes out of bounds. Pacers with it again.
And Nico Numeros comes onto the floor again. Jamil Wright out with the ball for the Pacers. Terry Horn to Devin Evans. Evans to Wright out. Horn to Dixon. Dixon for three off the mark. And that goes out of bounds. It'll be Pacer ball. Dixon 1-for-4 from the three-point line so far tonight after making his first. Johnson to right out. Right out. To Johnson, to Dixon, to Rideout. Shot clock at 6. Johnson with it now. Johnson for 3 with a hand in his face. Off the mark. Rebounded by Dixon. Dixon flips to Rideout. Rideout to the corner for Horn. Horn off the mark and rebounded by Gilmore Jr.
Tough right there for the Pacers. 3 rebounds and 3 missed threes. Gives the ball right back to Francis Marion.
Rideout knocks that ball loose but able to recover his beamer. Numeros with it now for the Patriots. Numeros loses the ball again, and it's right out with the ball. He flips it ahead to Dixon. Dixon drives, and the finger roll finish.
Great pass up. Pacers beat a 3-on-1 there to get to the basket.
Patriots have done a good job staying connected in this game, but the Pacers building a little bit of a lead for themselves here. 17 points. Numeros with it. Gilmore drives, flips to Beamer. Beamer fouled in the finish.
Pump fake there from Beamer. Got the defenders in the air, and he's able to go up strong, count the basket and one.
Chance for a three-point play here. A little bit of a break in the action here. I believe Beamer going to get his finger taped up. Well, all looks well now. After a little bit of maintenance on the sidelines, Beamer will take a spot at the free throw line to attempt the hoop and harm.
Beamer, the leading scorer on the floor for the Patriots right now with 8.
And no good on the three-point play opportunity. Ched Letdelva gets the rebound. To the corner for Horn. Horn fires a 3 off the mark. And that'll go out of bounds off of Chip Johnson. It'll be Patriot basketball.
Pacers have gone cold from the three-point line, but the Pacers' defense has been able to pick up, not allowing a lot of points from the Patriots.
Pacers getting it done inside, but again, as you mentioned, just going a little bit cold from the three-point line here in the second half of this first half. Johnson nearly taking that one away, but Beamer keeps possession. Jakes Jr. with it. He flips to Gilmore. Gilmore, bodied up by Ched Letdelva. He turns, he fires, and a finish over the big man.
Great job to fight his way into the interior there with the hook shot going up for 2.
Right out with the ball now. Right out to Johnson. Johnson with a hand in his face, and a lot of ill-advised three-pointers here. It's not just that they're missing. Terry Horn able to get the rebound, but again, it's not just that they're missing. They're taking bad shots now.
Absolutely. Johnson's shot there, a contested shot early in the shot clock. Speaking of which, there you go.
And he knocks that one down and had an argument for a foul on that play, but won't get it. Dixon doing a great job playing safety on that play coming up for the pick. Terry Horn waiting for the pressure and dropping the three-pointer in his face.
And just as we say the Pacers go cold, they go back-to-back possessions with back-to-back threes, extending their lead.
And a timeout taken by the Patriots, 47-28. Your score. We'll take a break. We'll be back in just a moment. Welcome back, everyone. 47-28, your score with 4:09 left here in the first half. Pacers, just as we were thinking, they went a little cold from three. Two back-to-back three-point buckets on back-to-back possessions. And their lead is stretched up to 19 now.
A great job there to be able to close out. Interesting there, the Patriots didn't have an inbounder for a few seconds.
And a foul called on that play. That's going to send Hudson Spivey to the line. That foul will go against Delva.
Spivey's first action collegiately for the Patriots here, but he is making the most of his time, getting to the free throw line multiple times and also hitting a three earlier in the half.
That free throw is off the mark. Jed LaDelva with his second foul will sit down. Simeon German comes in relief. Spivey knocks it down. So a 1-for-2 trip for him. He's 4-for-5 now on the day for the free throw line. Mill right out with the ball. Flips to Tyler Johnson. Now Demetrius Dixon with it. Dixon to right out. Right out. The screen from German. Right out. Throws it up. Off the mark. Rebounded by Gilmore.
Right out hung in the air a long time there. Almost looking to pass right before he shot.
That one goes down low. Dixon on the defense. German. And a walk. So it'll be Pacer basketball and a whistle. Now everything's all right. Jamil Wright out, flips to Tyler Johnson. Inside to Terry Horn. Horn goes up, and he's rejected by Gilmore.
Great job by Gilmore there to avoid the contact and get a clean block on Horn.
Jake's in transition, makes the finish at the rim. Dixon to Tyler Johnson. Johnson off the screen from German. Horn for three, wide open. And just rims out. German got the rebound, and he'll be fouled.
German able to pull that rebound, I think, when he came down to obtain the ball, someone came over and drew contact on him.
Yeah, they're going to call that against Spivey, his second of the first half. Flipped ahead. In the air, and it's going to be Horn with the ball. Horn drives to the corner. The three-pointer from right out off the mark. Johnson dives in for the rebound, but a foul.
Tyler Johnson going to be called there for an over-the-back foul. Came in very aggressively and drew contact. But the Patriots are in the bonus, so we'll be going to the free throw line.
And a big offensive half for Tyler Johnson already with 14 here in the first.
Yeah, but when the Pacers went 4-for-5 early from the three-point line, Tyler Johnson might have been three of those four, so he was able to get going early here and with 14 with 2 minutes left in the first half.
And knocks down the first free throw.
And substituting back on the floor for the Pacers, number 12, Jalen McCoy.
So a 2-for-2 trip there from Rollins. He's got five. Right out. Flips that ahead, and it'll be out of bounds off of St. Cyr, who dove in the way of the ball.
St. Cyr did a good job there to read Rideout's pass, almost being able to intercept it and take it the other way.
So Rideout will have the ball now. He gets it to Dixon. Dixon back to Horn to Rideout. Rideout inside to McCoy. McCoy turns, spins, fires, off the mark, and rebounded by Jakes. Jakes to Spivey. Spivey to Jakes. Defense! Gilmore down low. He flips it outside to Jakes for three. Off the mark, rebounded by Horn. Now Horn drives. Tyler Johnson will check back in. Horn, going to be fouled. That's going to go against St. Cyr. I know they'll say it's against Gilmore. Bryce Beamer also checking in now. Right out to Johnson. Johnson drives. Baseline jumper off the mark. And a whistle.
Looks like it's going to go against the Pacers.
That it is. It's going to go against German. And Beamer knocks down the first. And two for two there from the line. Johnson inside to McCoy, back to Johnson on the corner. Corner off the mark, missing everything. Beamer with the rebound. Minute and a half left to go. 12-point lead for the Pacers. Ball's loose. St. Cyr, he loses it to Rideout. Rideout now pushing the pace. Dixon with it. Dixon thought about a three, but instead he'll slow things down. Flips it over to Johnson. Johnson back to Rideout. Rideout now. Dixon with it. Dixon drives to the corner for Evans. Evans three. Off the mark. Rebounded by Johnson. Goes up strong. Turns. Fires. And it's going to be a turnover.
1 minute.
Jakes with the ball now for the Patriots. Jakes flips it inside. It's knocked loose and recovered by Devin Evans. Now Johnson has it. He flips it ahead to McCoy. McCoy guarded by Beamer. Off the mark. Rebounded by Jakes. So Jakes has the ball now. Three-pointer from Jakes, and that's on the money.
Just like that, this lead is back down to single digits.
Yeah, the Pacers had gotten the lead up to 19, but now it's back down to 9 with just 17 seconds left. No shot clock here. They'll play for the final shot of the half. Right out to Johnson. Johnson to Dixon. Dixon to McCoy. McCoy turns, fires, off the mark. Evans put back, no good. And Rollins, his shot will be after the shot clock, so it won't matter either way. But a 47-38 lead for the Pacers after the first half. Pacers, had gotten the lead up to 19, but it shrank down to 9 before the end of the half. We will take a break, and we'll be back with the second half in about 15 minutes. Welcome back, everyone, to the second half of this men's basketball contest between USC Aiken Pacers and the Francis Marion Patriots. Second half presented by the South Carolina Education Lottery, where you're not only taking a chance, you're giving a chance. Pacers with a 47-38 lead. Jordan Phillips joined by Reese Altman on the call for you today as that ball is knocked loose and recovered by Devin Evans. Jamil Rideout will bring the ball up. Terry Horn has it now. Horn flips to McCoy. Johnson to the corner for Rideout. Rideout, long pass over to Horn. Inside to McCoy now. McCoy backing down. McCoy to the corner for Rideout, who fires a three. Hand in his face, missing everything, and rebounded by Watara.
Yeah, Pacers finished that first half 9 for 25 from the free throw line after Rideout's miss right there. Make it 9 for 26 on the game as the Patriots convert the first points here in the second half and cut the lead down to 7, what was 19.
Yeah, a little bully ball there from Watara. Tyler Johnson has it. He flips it back to Rideout. Now back to Johnson once again. Across to Rideout now. Rideout to Horn. Horn to Rideout again. Rideout back to Horn. Rideout fires three and knocks one down. Finally getting the Pacers back in the right side of that column. So a 50-40 lead now for the Pacers as Watara goes to work against Jalen McCoy. Ball is loose. It's on the ground. Beamer has it. He gets it out to Watara. Driving now and a foul. That's going to go against Watara. It'll be offensive foul.
Looked to be a push off there under the basket. Give the ball back to the Pacers.
A little too active there with his hands. Rideout now running. Slowing down things now. Rideout to Johnson. McCoy. Back to Rideout. Rideout the pump fake. Johnson again. Johnson drive. Johnson at the rim. Throws it up and the finish through contact.
Strong finish there from Johnson driving in. Wasn't sure if he drew contact or not, but was able with a strong finish to go up and put in two.
Beamer backing down on Johnson. Lowers the shoulder, gets a little separation, and knocks down the fadeaway. Jamil Rideout with the ball now. Rideout to Johnson.
Patriots Johnson coming out here in a 2-3 zone to start off as well.
Yeah, different look, and that ball's knocked away by Watara. Jake's Jr. finger roll finish in transition.
Tough defense there for Rideout. He went up against a 3-on-1, took the pass, and Jake's was able to take it to the basket for two.
Johnson now driving to Devin Evans. And he'll be fouled.
The foul was on number three, Bryce Beamer.
That's Bryce Beamer, his first of the contest.
And at the line shooting two, number 21, Devin Evans.
So Evans at the free throw line now. Off the mark on the first.
And Evans shooting just under 50% on the season from the free throw line. Missing the first there.
So one for two trip there from Evans. Beamer with the ball. He's guarded by Johnson. Losing the ball. Johnson made a run for it, couldn't get it. It's Teon Rollins. Rollins the fadeaway. And nice shot there from Teon Rollins to get the finish.
Patriots coming out hot here in the second half, hitting big shots early to get to cut away at the Pacer lead.
Terry Horn with the ball. He flips it inside to Jalen McCoy. McCoy going to be fouled. That's on Beamer.
McCoy and Beamer picking up each other defensively here. I believe Beamer is the reigning Conference Carolinas Player of the Week. McCoy, the reigning Peach Butt Player of the Week. Back-to-back fouls on Beamer there as well. He's already up to two. Something to watch here in the second half.
And McCoy off the mark on the first.
for Francis Marion is number 5, Brady St. Cyr.
An 0-for-2 trip there for McCoy. Terry Horn, he'll say it's out off him.
A good effort there from Terry Horn to try and get the ball, but does look like it went off his fingertips, which will give the ball to Francis Marion.
So it'll be Tion Rollins bringing the ball up. Rollins to Jakes, back to Rollins. Rollins to Gilmore, now to Rollins again. Rollins to Jakes. Jakes ahead to Gilmore. That would have been a beautiful play if he had been able to finish it. Just a little bit too much on the pass. He couldn't quite haul it in.
The no-look alley-oop pass was beautifully thrown, just unable to finish at the basket.
That was nearly a highlight reel play for the Patriots, but off the mark on the finish. Terry Horn with the ball now. He flips to Jameel Rideout. Right out to Evans, and a foul.
Foul was on number 5 for Reed St. Cyr. That's his first and the team's fourth.
Right out, flips to Horn. Horn, fire. Off the mark from right out on the three-pointer, rebounded by Gilmore.
Strong rebound there by Gilmore. That ball high in the air for a long time.
St. Cyr finds Gilmore. Gilmore driving in against Delva, and a whistle. And a travel they're going to call.
Took one too many steps there on the drive. The Pacers caught a break as Delva drew a lot of contact on the drive.
Yeah, big break there for the Pacers on that travel. But a whistle and a timeout. And that'll be our first full media timeout of the second half. We'll take a break. 53-46, your score. Welcome back, everyone. Second half of this men's basketball contest between the USC Aiken Pacers and Francis Marion Patriots. 53-46 out of the timeout. 15:38 left in the second half. Dwight Kennedy Jr., Rajon Blackwell, Demetrius Dixon, Simeon German, Devin Evans on the floor for the Pacers. Dixon gets it to Blackwell, who drives. Blackwell to the corner for Dixon for three, and he drops it in.
High arcing shot there from Dixon. Struggled from behind the line in the first half. We'll see if we can get things going here as the minutes tick down here in the second.
Barrett St. Cyr shot off the mark. Rebounded by the Pacers. Dixon in transition. And a beautiful finish there from Demetrius Dixon. I have no idea how he got that shot to fall.
Dixon, 5 quick points here for the Pacers to push the lead back over to 12 points, over double digits again.
And he's in double digits on the game for himself, 10 points. Driving in, off of a Pacer. Kennedy gets the ball. He feeds it ahead to Dixon. Dixon back to Evans. Evans misses the dunk. And Gilmore.
Oh, my goodness.
Gilmore just tried to commit a felony right there on that one. That was violent in the charge called, but my goodness. Credit to Simeon German putting his body on the line. That was a beautiful jump there.
I am not going to lie. It looked like he jumped from the three-point line. He full extension there. My goodness.
That was a lot of height on that jump from Gilmore, and he nearly he nearly put Simeon German on a poster. But either way, a charge called.
Well, unique situation there. Back-to-back missed dunks for either side.
Rarely do you see that, but Pacers will have the ball, no harm, no foul, one way or the other, to the corner for Blackwell for three, off the mark, and rebounded by Beamer. Pacers, Patriots pushing the transition now. Jakes with the ball. Beamer with it down low. He's trapped to the corner for St. Cyr. His three-pointer is off the mark, rebounded by Jakes. Jakes turns, blocked by German. I think German might have taken that last play a little personally there on that block. Dixon with the ball now. He drives back to German. German to Evans. Evans thought about it. He flips to Blackwell instead. Blackwell slowing things down now. Cross-court pass to Dixon. Dixon falls down. Flips to Evans. Evans goes inside. Off the mark. Punched in the air by German. And it'll be out off of a Patriot.
Surprised there wasn't a foul or a travel called there on Dixon. Usually when you do lose your footing, they call something on the floor, but I believe he just...
A technical foul has been charged to number zero, Horace James.
I believe the call there is that there was contact, which would have caused Dixon to lose his footing, and so it wasn't just like he just fell down. I believe the contact, which they're going to say, caused that.
Right, sorry, I lost my train of thought on that sentence. I heard a technical foul was called on the floor, so I wanted to see what was going on.
And Rajon Blackwell knocks down the technical free throw. He'll have another one. So two free points for the Pacers there, and they'll have possession. That brings Adonis Cole into the game.
The Pacers push the lead back up to 14 here. The flow of the game has been so back and forth. Both teams have been able to pull momentum from either side almost immediately. We'll see what how things play out here down the stretch.
Dixon with the ball now. Dixon drives. Trying to draw contact there. Won't get the whistle, and now there will be a foul called.
And Dixon earlier in this first half as well, making a big effort from the three-point line. Now doing a great job of getting to the interior. That's his, I believe, his third shot back-to-back-to-back that came inside the paint.
Knifing his way there inside. German will shoot two. German knocks down the first. Two-for-two trip there from German. Long pass ahead to Jakes. Jakes to St. Cyr, to Rollins, to St. Cyr, to Jakes again. Jakes thought about it, flips it inside to Rollins, to the corner for Spivey, off the mark, rebounded by the Pacers. Rajon Blackwell with the ball now. Blackwell to Evans, to the corner for Dixon. Dixon pump fake. Dixon step back to Evans again for three. Knocks it down.
Great ball movement once again by the Pacers. Finding that open man. One extra shot, converting another three-pointer on the evening.
Using ball movement to generate open looks on that play. Now Rollins will have it. The Pacer lead is 19.
That ties their biggest lead that was in the first half as well.
So that's going to bring Marlo Gilmore back onto the floor. Rollins on the inbound, look for somebody. And a whistle. Foul on the floor called. That's going to go against German. Ball's inbounded to Spivey. Spivey fakes the three, drives, flips to Rollins. Rollins turns, fires off the mark, rebounded by Blackwell.
Tough break there from the Patriots. They're getting good looks in the interior of this Pacer defense, just been unable to get them to fall thus far.
Blackwell with a long two-point basket there. Gives the Pacers a 21-point lead. Three-pointer from Rollins off the mark. Rebounded by St. Cyr, but he loses the ball. Oh. It's a foot race for it. Real physical play there. I believe it's going to be Patriot basketball.
A lot of bodies on the floor. Looked to be about 6 of the 10 players at one point diving for that ball in front of the Patriots bench. But everybody up under their own power. Glad to see that.
St. Cyr, a long three-pointer off the mark. And that'll be Pacer basketball.
Smart by the Pacers there just to let the ball go out of bounds. No one around to try and pull it back in either.
So now Dixon will bring the ball up. Pacers crossing half court. To Evans. And Dixon now with it. Dixon, a nice Euro step to get the finish.
Beautiful finish there from Dixon. Another great job getting to the basket quickly on the interior of the defense.
Spivey with the ball. Spivey to Jakes off the mark on his three-pointer. Rebounded by German. Flips it ahead to Evans. Evans gets the ball up. Evans flips inside to Kennedy. Kennedy finishes.
Strong pass from Evans. Look at the Patriots almost anticipating the shot for the basket. But he's able to get it to Evans for two.
And a big note here. The Pacers already in the bonus here in this second half with over 11 minutes to go. So any foul from the Patriots from here on out will send them to the line. To the corner for Jakes. Off the mark. Or excuse me, that was Rollins. Jakes with the rebound. To the top of the key for St. Cyr. And he drops down the three.
Finally getting one to fall. Patriots were ice cold from the three-point line.
Pacers with the ball now to Dixon. Dixon to Kennedy. Now to Blackwell. Dixon has it again. Dixon off the screen from German. Over to the top into German's hands. And a nice easy finish there from German. Nice feed from Dixon.
St. Cyr almost was able to get that ball on the backside, but German was able to keep it high and put it up for two.
Gilmore with the ball now to Jakes. Jakes for three. Off the mark, rebounded by German. Pushing the pace, Evans with the ball. Evans goes up. Evans with the one-handed rim scraper.
He's able to finish that time on the flush. Pacers up big, extending the lead here.
That takes us into our full media timeout. We will take a break. 75-49 your score. We'll be back in about 1 minute. Welcome back, everyone. Today's second half presented by Tyler's Tire and Auto Center for all your automotive needs. Go over to Tyler's Tire and Auto Center and let them know USC Aiken Athletics sent you. 75-49 score here. Just over 10 minutes left in the first half. Second half, excuse me. On the floor now for the Patriots, Willie Patterson III. along with Chandler O'Bannon. St. Cyr with the ball now. St. Cyr to that's a three-pointer from Numeros, and that's going to be out of bounds. It'll be Pacer ball. And another timeout taken. That's going to be a full timeout. We will take a break, and we'll be back in about 1 minute. Welcome back, everyone. Pacers on top here, 75-49 with 9:45 left in the second half. Pacers finding their rhythm offensively here in the second half. Blackwell driving. Blackwell pulls up, hangs in the air off the mark. Ball's on the ground, and a foul call that's going to go against Devin Evans.
Devin Evans a little too physical there, trying to steal the ball away, but the Patriots player was already in control of it.
It's a little too active on that one for him.
That's only this Pacers' second foul here in the second half.
Three-pointer from O'Bannon off the mark, rebounded by German. German to Blackwell. Blackwell drives to Dixon to the corner for Kennedy for three off the mark. Ball's loose, but rebounded by Watara. Watara drives, flips to O'Bannon for three off the mark, rebounded by Kennedy, going up big for that one. That ball hits German in the face, but he's going to be okay. He's up. Blackwell to Evans. Blackwell back to Evans again. Now to Dixon. Dixon to Evans. Evans to Blackwell. Now to Dixon again. Dixon the screen from German. Flips to the corner. One on the shot clock. Off the mark. And it'll be out off of a Pacer.
Looks like they're going to keep it here. I believe the went off of one of the Francis Marion defenders.
So it will. Demetrius Dixon will do the inbounding duties.
And it might be unique here for the Pacers as well. Usually we got to see them shoot early and aggressively in the shot clock. But with a big lead up late, I would imagine to get the shots down. Shot clock down to under 5 seconds before they take a shot.
Dixon taking a long three-pointer, and he knocks it down. That stretches the lead to 29 for the Pacers. They're likely going to see a lot of long possessions here going forward from the Pacers. The drive and the whistle. It's going to be a blocking foul against Dwight Kennedy Jr.
Yeah, expect to see a lot of substitutions from Coach Vanderslice as well. I don't think I've seen Terry Horn or Jalen McCoy or Tyler Johnson on the floor since the early part of the second half. And, you know, the crazy part about this is also is when we started in the coming out of halftime, this is a nine-point game. Pacers have an explosion on the offensive side here in the second half.
And that is the case. It's another full media timeout. We will take a break. We'll be back in just a moment. Welcome back, everyone. Today's contest presented by Aiken Flooring. Aiken Flooring, you can stand on us. 78-49 lead for the Pacers over the Francis Marion Patriots. The three-pointer taken and off the mark, and a whistle.
The foul was on the Pacers, number one, right side Blackwell.
That was against Blackwell. So the inbound goes to Numeros. Numeros to Patterson for three, off the mark, and rebounded by Kennedy. Pacers slowing things down here, no rush for them. Dixon has the ball. Dixon dribbling around to Evans now. That's to German. Now to Dixon. Dixon drives. Dixon puts it up, off the mark. Nearly got another circus shot from Demetrius Dixon right there.
About to say, not the first time we have seen that this afternoon.
And Willie Patterson gets the Patriots on the board. It's been a while since they've hit a three. Gone ice cold here in this second half from that point. 4 of 21 prior to that shot, so 5 of 22 now. And Dwight Kennedy gets the bucket there. Pacers set to have a near full shift change. You'll see, and they will have a full shift change. It'll be Tyler Johnson, Terry Horn, Chedlet Delva, Jalen McCoy, and Jameel Rideout checking in for the Pacers after that three-pointer.
About to say Evans already on the floor, but it appears to be the starting five coming back out for the Pacers here as they continue to put it in the basket.
They're finding their buckets here. Numeros to Patterson. Patterson, long two-pointer, knocks it down.
By number 24, Willie Patterson.
Evans with the ball now. Evans down low to German. He's going to be fouled. That'll send German to the line.
Looks like he was held trying to get to that basket. And they've been in the bonus for a while now, so German will go to the line.
That's his first in the team to eight this half.
Substituting in. He's going to bring in everyone but Delva. Spivey, Hudson Spivey back on the floor now for the Patriots.
And at the charity strike will be number 24, Sidney and Garman for 1 and 1.
Off the mark, but rebounded by McCoy. Ball is loose, but finally Jameel Rideout comes to it, and a foul.
The physical play for that rebound there. It looks like they're going to get German on a foul.
They will.
The foul is on the base, number 24, Simeon Gehrman. That's his third. It's the team's fifth.
So 5:36 left. Chedlet Delva checks into the floor now.
Chedlet Delva.
Patterson on the drive, the flip to O'Bannon. O'Bannon turns, he's rejected by Delva. Terry Horn with the ball now. Horn driving. Rideout with the ball. Rideout loses the ball. O'Bannon loses it as well, but Spivey able to maintain possession, and the Pacers now, Patriots now pushing the pace to the corner. Long pass over to Spivey. Spivey drives, loses the ball.
Another save there from Tyler Johnson. Unfortunately, his momentum took him out of bounds.
Yeah, just stepped out on that one, so it'll be Patriot basketball. Jai Gadden will inbound. Gadden on the inbound. It's O'Bannon with it now. O'Bannon guarded by Horn. He puts up A little fadeaway off the mark, rebounded by Delva. It's knocked loose, but it'll be out off of Jose Figueroa. Tyler Johnson has the ball left wide open on the three-point line, off the mark. Delva tried to get it. He tips it to Jalen McCoy, who gets the finish. And Terry Horn with a beautiful play there. Gets around the defender and the easy finish in transition.
Great read there from Terry Horn to intercept that long pass, something we've seen a lot of from the Patriots here this evening. Quick inbound passes and long transition passes to get the ball up the floor.
Now both teams running right now. Tyler Johnson with it. Johnson, the Euro, draws the contact and one.
Tyler Johnson picking up right where he left off. Have not seen him much here in the second half, but still that burst of energy the Pacers always seem to need when he's on the floor.
Yeah, the Pacers went a long way without seeing any action from McCoy, Rideout, Johnson, or Terry Horn, but all of them back on the floor now. And a whistle. I believe it's going to be a lane violation on Delva.
We have a lane violation. Patriot basketball.
So it'll be Patriot ball. Ball's loose, and it'll be Pace. It'll remain with Francis Marion.
Physical defense from right out there, not letting him get up the floor very much. Been takes us into a full media timeout.
So we'll take a break, and we'll be back with the end of the second half here in just about a minute. Welcome back, everyone. 3:58 left here in the second half. 89-59 your score. Pacers with a commanding lead over the Francis Marion Patriots. The drive from O'Bannon, he flips to Patterson. Patterson can't finish. But again, there's Spivey flying in and taking the rebound away from Terry Horn. The floater off the mark, rebounded by Delva. Horn with the ball. McCoy now to Johnson. Johnson back to Rideout. Rideout drives the fadeaway off the mark. Rebounded by McCoy. McCoy spins and the finish.
Jalen McCoy.
And I believe that's going to be a foul.
Aggressive push there from Patterson on the offensive side, taking it coast to coast himself.
And that's going to go against Jalen McCoy.
Visiting the charity strike, Willie Patterson.
Patterson knocks down the first. And 2 for 2 from the line there from Patterson. 30-point lead for the Pacers. 3 minutes and 13 seconds left here in the second half. Johnson for three, off the mark, rebounded by Spivey. That was, he loses that one, and it's going to be Patriot ball. That was Jai Gadden on the drive.
Patriots still aggressively finding their way to the basket, just not getting a lot of shots to fall right now.
Patterson with the ball and a blocking foul against Johnson.
Foul was on number three of the Pacers, Tyler Johnson. That's his second. It's the team seven. A visit to the charity strike for Willie Patterson, 1-1.
Knocking down the first free throw is Patterson. Off the mark, rebounded by Delva. Flipped ahead to Horn. Now to McCoy. Horn gets it to Johnson. And Johnson knocks down the corner three.
3-point basket, Tyler Johnson.
Tyler Johnson active offensively and defensively, right in the mix of all of the loose ball there.
Nearly took that away. Corner three off the mark, rebounded by Rideout, but it's loose and recovered by the Patriots. But that'll be out of bounds off of O'Bannon. It'll go back to the Pacers.
Mass substitution coming in here for the Pacers.
Going to see Melvin Archie, Devin Evans, Jamie Pierre-Louis, Samarian Bond, and Simeon German on the floor now. So Evans, German, Bond, Jamie Pierre-Louis on the floor, Melvin Archie on the floor. German with the ball. German to Evans. Three-pointer from Melvin Archie from the corner, off the mark. Flipped ahead, and it'll be taken away by Jamie Pierre-Louis. Minute 50 on the clock, 94-62 your score. Likely, again, going to see some long possessions here from the Pacers. Samarian Bond takes the three-pointer, off the mark, rebounded by Evans again. Evans goes up, and he's fouled.
Great positioning there by Evans on the backside block, able to pull the rebound and go up strong again. Draws the contact, heading to the line for two.
Going to the line to shoot two for the Pacers, Devin Evans.
And off the mark on that. Over two trip there from Evans. O'Bannon with the ball for the Patriots. Patterson drives. That's slapped away by Jamie Pierre-Louis. But it'll be out of bounds off the Pacers. It'll be Patriot basketball. Both teams in the bonus now.
Been a lot of fouls called here in the second half. So moving forward, both teams, no matter what, will head to the free throw line.
Patterson with the ball. He spins, and he's fouled.
Hard foul there. Patterson doing an excellent job getting inside on Pacer defenders, going to the basket strong.
That one's good for the free throw for there for Patterson. And a 2-for-2 trip there from Patterson. Minute 20 left. Pierre-Louis bringing the ball up. He loses it. and a kickball.
3-on-2 break there for the Patriots. Good job. I believe that was Evans on the backside, able to get his foot in the way to stop the transition basket.
Off the mark there.
Pulled by German on the backside block.
Archie with the ball. Archie to Pierre Louis. Pierre Louis thought about a three. Back to Archie. Archie loses the ball, and it'll be out off of the Patriots. Pierre Louis with the ball, and a foul. Foul on Jai Gladden that time. And 2-for-2 that time. 43 seconds left on the clock. Pacers look to be in firm control of this one.
Didn't always appear that way, but a great way to end the game here for the Pacers.
Pierre Louis with the ball, long three, and Pierre Louis knocks it down. A little insult to injury on that one from Pierre Louis. A 35-point lead for the Pacers. That one's thrown across the floor. Shot clock is off, and a foul. That's German's fourth foul of the contest. 13 seconds left.
Visiting the charity line, it's number 12, Matthew Lee.
Two for two, and you're going to see the Pacers most likely just dribble this one out. And it'll be out of bounds off the Patriots. Patriots to the corner. Spivey's three, missing everything, and that will do it. 99-66, the Pacers take the victory here over the Patriots. Their sixth in a row. Again, a close game at halftime there, but just an offensive explosion from the Pacers here in the second half.
It was. Both teams came out very strong. Pacers jumped out early. Francis Marion was able to fight their way back. But as we said earlier, Pacers just had a great start to the second half offensively, and that lead grew from 9 to 29 very quickly. So all around great performance today for USC Aiken.
Great performance after a great half there in the second half, 52-point half for the Pacers. But for Reese Altman, I'm Jordan Phillips. Thank you guys so much for watching, and we'll see you next time.